Back exploring the rich history of Johns Hopkins. In his book, Leading the Way, author Neil Grauer looks at the history of Johns Hopkins Medicine. And when we say he wrote the book, it is a very heavy, big book on Johns Hopkins. This is amazing. How long did this take you to write?
3.5 years.
And reaction so far?
Has been very good. Very good.
Why did you write this book?
Well, there hadn't been a major history of Johns Hopkins for more than 20 years, mm-hmm. and a great deal has happened over the past 20 years in American medicine and at Hopkins itself. And also, we were in the midst of one of the largest hospital reconstruction projects in the history of the United States, the building of the new clinical towers at Johns Hopkins Hospital,
right.
which opened earlier this year. And so they wanted a book to come out in conjunction with that.
To sort of illustrate what it is they've done, how the hospital's expanded.
And all of the new developments over the past 20 years, which include the winning of two Nobel Prizes, several Presidential Medals of Freedom, several National Medals of Science, several MacArthur Genius Awards, quite a lot.
Obviously, Hopkins gets its reputation because of its many firsts that have happened there at the hospital. Mm-hmm. Can you talk about some of those?
Well, I mean, going back to the founding of the medical school in 1893, it was the first medical school in the United States to admit women on an equal basis with men. And it also was the first medical school that required applicants to have a undergraduate college degree. And it is the birthplace of American pediatrics, the birthplace of urology, the birthplace of neurosurgery in the United States.
Often called the Big Four.
The Big Four were the founding physicians of Hopkins mm-hmm. Medicine. William Welsh, who was the first dean of the School of Medicine. William Halstead, who's the founder of modern antiseptic surgery
There's
in the United States.
Of the painting there.
Yeah, that's a famous painting by John Singer Sargent, and that's Welsh on the left, Halstead standing behind him. Going to the right is Sir William Osler, who was the finest internist and educator. And oh, that's a picture of Levi Watkins, who implanted the first automatic defibrillator in the world at Hopkins in 1980. That's Kofi Bohini, who, along with Dr. Alfredo Quinones Hinosa, invented a new way of removing brain tumors by going through a patient's eyelid.
And he's also known as Dr. Q, is that right?
Dr.
Yes.
Q, well, not this fellow.
But the
other one
the,
is the famous Dr.
Yes, the
Q.
one that you were talking about.
Right,
that's
and
right.
That's Pete Agre, who in 2003 won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry for discovering the protein aquaporins. And that's a picture of a test run, so to speak, on a surgery with Ben Carson in 1968. He was the first to separate conjoined twins who were joined at the head.
It had to have been so exciting to write this book and to really explore everything that Hopkins has done and the people who have contributed all these years.
Very much so, and it was also a great honor to meet a lot of these individuals. To a person, they were extraordinarily helpful and gracious and cooperative, and they reflected the Hopkins ethos, which is collegiality.
And if we want to find this book?
You can find it on the Johns Hopkins Press website and other websites that sell books and at the Barnes & Noble bookstores.
Okay, this is a marvelous book. Stan Stovall would like you to sign it before you leave, if you would, please. Great coffee table book, great Christmas gift. Thank you so much for coming in. Certainly appreciate it.
My honor. Thank you very
nice
much.
Nice to meet you. You're so welcome. And please don't go.